Welcome to a new SiteGround video. My name is Cal Evans, and today we're going to learn what object caching is and how to speed up your WordPress-based website by implementing it. After that, I'll show you two different options for caching and which one you should be using. Do you want to make your website faster? Hint, if you said no, hit the stop button now and go play the 9-hour video of a fireplace. Everybody wants to make their website faster because time is money. There are a few different ways you can make your website faster. One of the most effective ways is caching your website. Thanks to caching, you can speed up your site without needing to take such drastic actions as getting rid of all your JavaScript, CSS, and graphics, or constantly upgrading your hosting resources. There is a better option, and that option is what we're here to talk about, object caching. Object caching is a technique used to take the results of an expensive procedure and store them for reuse. Let me translate that out of geek speak for you. When a process, like talking to the database to get a list of available blog posts, takes a long time to execute, we can store the results of that process, and the next time we just use the stored results instead of running the process again. The act of storing the results is what we mean in computers when we say caching. There are a lot of things that can benefit from object caching. For example, on one of my websites, I want to show the high tide and weather information for a specific site that scuba divers like to dive. To do this, I have to make queries to 4 different APIs. Now, weather information doesn't really change that much. Once I have the results from those 4 APIs, I use object caching to store those results. Then, for the rest of the day, I use my locally stored copies of that information. My site runs faster because I'm not having to wait on the APIs to return. And I don't put unnecessary load on the servers running the APIs, so they can serve more sites like mine. It's really a win-win. Database queries are also a great candidate for caching. Many database servers have built-in database caching mechanisms. Still, if we cache at the application level, then we don't even have to talk to the database to display our results. Anything that takes a while to execute and returns data that can be stored for a period of time is a candidate for object caching. Many systems use special services that are designed to store pieces of data in memory and retrieve them quickly. Implementing these type of services into your site is how you can implement object caching. Now, the most common of these services is called Memcached. Memcached has been around for a long time and is probably the most popular memory caching service. It speeds up websites by storing or caching the results of everything from database queries to API calls in the server's memory. If the results are needed again, they'll just be pulled from the server's memory. Memcached is well supported by both WordPress plugins and hosts. And these days, the best hosting partners, like SiteGround, set up a Memcached server for you automatically. Then it's just a matter of setting up a plugin to use it. If you're hosting with SiteGround, the SG Optimizer plugin gives the option to use Memcached. WordPress has many plugins that will help you set up caching. In most cases, they require that you understand a lot more about caching and servers. There is one very easy solution though, the SiteGround Optimizer plugin. This is by far the easiest way I've found to implement object caching in WordPress. Let's see how to do it. To enable caching on any site hosted at SiteGround.com, first, go to Site Tools for that site. Click on Speed and then Caching. Come over to the Memcached tab. Here, you should see that Memcached is turned off. Click the slider to turn it on. a pop-up will notify you that it was successfully enabled. Now that takes care of the server side. Now let's tell WordPress to use it. To do that, you need a plugin. Go to your WordPress admin dashboard, click on Plugins, and then Add New. In the search box, enter SiteGround Optimizer and then press the Enter key. Now, find the SiteGround Optimizer plugin and click on Install. Once it's installed, click on the Activate button. Now we have a new menu item, SG Optimizer. Click it and then come down to Caching and click that. Yes, we should allow them to collect data to improve the reliability of the plugin. Now there are three types of caching, and I recommend you turn them all on one at a time. Today, however, we're only interested in that last one, Memcached. Go over and click the slider to enable Memcached. A pop-up will let you know that it was successful. Object caching helps speed up your website by storing the results of expensive procedures so they can be reused. The fewer times you have to execute expensive procedures, the faster your site will run. If your hosting partner gives you access to these tools, like SiteGround does, then by all means, make use of them. If not, consider looking for a hosting partner that does give you these tools. Now, I want to hear from you. Is caching part of your website management routine? Have you implemented Memcached? Leave me a comment below. Hey, I want to thank you for joining us today as we learned. I hope you found it both educational and interesting. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click on the subscribe button on your screen to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the bell icon also so that YouTube will notify you every time we release a new video. Finally, follow us on social media to stay up to date about all the news, trending comments, and resources for successful website management that we share. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.